Beautiful. I love it. Beautiful. Perfect. No notes. Hi. Happy Sunday. Yesterday was a boatload of fun, and I'm going to be playing more Satisfactory on stream in the future. That's going to happen.
Did you play any off stream?
No, I haven't. I got done yesterday. I got the hell out of here, went and ate my prime rib, and then went and passed out.
The prime rib alarm went off.
Yeah, yesterday it was the prime rib alarm, so I was like, nope, can't do that today. Gotta go. Yeah. Oh, it was so good. It was so good. It was good again tonight too when I ate more of it. It was delicious. So yeah, enjoy. Love when prime rib goes on sale for religious holidays. So great. Huh. Well, hello to
or
ads.
For any reason, really.
That's also true. Hello to ads and Viv and Carses and Fritz.
Wait, what?
Probably not, Carsus. I might have enough for like one, but like a scant amount. We'll see how
it
goes.
I say it's Fritz's first time here.
Whoa. Is it? I don't know. Yeah, that's probably. It's very.
Should you like change account names or something? Maybe I don't.
No, I don't. I think
like change the capitalization.
No, maybe. Yeah. Oh, Fritz, did you? Yeah, did you maybe? Yeah, that's true. That's true. You do usually. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Good point. Good point.
Well, it did me. I couldn't confuse.
I was like, Fritz has been. He's been here the whole time, man. Yeah. Right. Yeah. Right. Is he? Also, hi, Warbear. How you doing, pal? All right. So tonight I'm getting back into Bear and Breakfast. So far, no breakfast, only bear, but that's okay. We'll get through it, and we'll continue enjoying being, I don't know, playing Zunder Simulator. I guess this is what it is. I guess, yeah, let's go. Nice, Izzy. Doop-a-doop-doop-doop. Timber Crossing. Okay. Fucking love this game. This game is great. It's fantastic.
I am watching an automobile race for those curious.
An automobile race. Love that. Tomorrow we'll see the delivery of your new PC now repaired and hopefully fully operational. Hopefully it will be a fully operational battle station. I'm thinking good vibes for you, bud. Let's see. Let's see.
NASCAR on Bristol Dirt. Sort of, Viv.
A little bit.
The thing with dirt racing is you have to turn right in order to turn left.
Yeah. It's very drifty. Because, you see, it's not as solid of a surface as, like, you know, asphalt.
You know, their natural habitat.
Right.
Like, these cars don't want to be on this surface.
No, they do not.
I don't know why they forced them there.
No, the stock cars are enjoy their natural habitat of the asphalt. Okay, raise the prestige level to level 4 in Timber Crossing. What are we? How close are we to level 4 here? Not terribly close. Hope everyone had a good weekend. I certainly had a great time yesterday. That was so much fun. Cannot wait to play more of the Satisfactories. cushioned footrest and small vanity table. I'll hold off on that for right now. Okay. Let's see. Showed up over here. Nifty. Okay. Complete the stay for plus 3 guests at A24. Oh, I have to go down here anyway. I think I still have to go over here.
Under there?
Yes.
Eh.
Yeah, there he is. Nice, Viv. Viv, do you got D&D tonight? Ooh, get all kinds of stuff.
Actually, here. Due to the current state of the economy, it is now Dungeons or Dragons.
I didn't remember what night it was, Viv, that's all. Is Dungeons or Dragons?
Yep. They can't afford both anymore.
Oof. Dungeons and Dragons in this economy? Oh, what's this that I missed up here? A destroyed couch.
Biweekly sounds smarter to me.
Oh, I see. Okay. So I was on the right track.
It's the most fun ever at first, but
hi there, Bard Girl.
It's no different.
This is Bear and Breakfast, or basically me simulator. Because, you know, that's pretty much it. Yeah. It's very chill and very, very great. I never played D&D until it'd be chaotic. Yes, just all chaotic. Yeah, it's fantastic. Oh, I could put on my hat. Let me put on my hat. There we go. There.
That's good hat wearing.
Thanks. I'll do the, But Bard Girl, it's good to see you. How you been? Wow. That's... Viv, that's hurtful. That hurts. Last time you went to a dirt trackways. That was the worst we moved. Tony Stewart purchased the track. Oh, Tony Stewart.
Tony Stewart is commentating this race.
Fantastic.
He's got his hair all slicked back and he looks like he joined the mob.
Tony Stewart has gone full bibbity bobbity.
I've already decided that if I ever played D&D that my character would be a bard, but I would be the loot goblin, but it would just be because I have a loot that I would play.
Perfect. Proudly chaotic adult-ish. There you go.
I have no idea where that falls on any of the whatever.
Yes, loot goblin. Exactly that, Viv. That's correct. Making that character right now.
But then I would also strictly refuse to ever collect actual loot.
Yes. So you'd be the anti-loot loot goblin. Turn the lights off. Oh, can I turn the lights off in the kitchen? You got lights in this kitchen?
I don't know any cooking recipes. That almost indicates that you might learn some at some point.
I wonder if I will learn cooking recipes in the game called Bear and Breakfast.
Don't know.
Turn the lights off. Carry da 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 da. You know, and other such things. Let's see.
Uh-oh. Oh, they're wrecking.
Oh, right. Let's see. Can I... No, that's fine.
Yeah, a lot of these guys don't know what the fuck they're doing. It's too much car and not the correct track for it.
Hmm. I guess I can just... Yeah. Let's just sleep. There's not much I can do right now. Do the sleps. Love a good slip. Doodaloo-loo! Eight, one, and... let's see if I can get a... I need to clean up anything in here? No? Hello. Welcome in. I am Bear. Mission on dirt car is just so much different. Oh, I can imagine. I can imagine so. Alright. Barfly? Sure.
I tell you what. If Liberty Mutual does a commercial that's just, I don't know, 90 seconds of Doug getting the shit kicked out of him, yeah. I'll switch tomorrow.
Yeah. What if it's Limu Emu kicking the shit out of Doug? Would you switch today?
No, I think the Emu's gotta go too.
Oh, yeah? What if, like, future ones.
Do we know?
Like what if it's.
Do
what
we
if
know any Aussies?
Do we know any Aussies? I can't think of any, no.
Because they hate emus.
I don't know. I don't think that we have any.
Wait. Where's Domi?
No. He's not Aussie. He's just hanging upside down. It's.
Like a. Bat?
Yes, exactly like that.
Dummy's a bat?
Yes, he's a bat. He just likes us to think that he's Aussie. It's an elaborate ruse. So, I'm assuming that has to be for the cookins. Alright, let's,
I don't know. I think it's time to kill Doug off.
Yeah. What if
I
what
mean
if,
we want to make sure he is dead. I don't want him coming back down the line anywhere.
Don't want to risk it. Let's see. Alright, what do we got here? They both leave tomorrow. Let's see what we got here.
Like, they kill him, then they put him in the trunk of a car that they bring to the junkyard, and they put it in the compactor, and then the compactor turns the car into a cube. And then a meteor hits the junkyard. Like, no chance of recovery.
That's, I can see it.
The Liberty Mutual guy that's fucking that emu.
Limu Emu. And Doug.
I've had enough of him, and I think it's time to kill him off, is what I'm saying.
Yeah. Yes, Tom hates Doug. Alright, now I can craft a couple more things and stuff.
It was sensible chuckle-worthy for, like, maybe the first commercial or two.
Like, yeah.
When he wanted his own helicopter? Yeah, okay. Ha ha ha. But now he's, like, following a dude through the car wash, like, all creepy-like.
Oops.
Nah. Time to go.
Let's see. Cushion footrest. Ooh, let's do a couple of those.
It's the drone. Good job, drone.
Can I sell stuff in this game? I don't know that I can. I gotta find it.
Can you what?
Sell stuff. Like,
I thought that's what the raccoon was for. Or can you only buy stuff from him?
I don't think I can. I don't think I can sell things to him. I would love to, like,
I thought you could sell stuff. Nope. Oh, there it is. Why aren't you over here, Mary? Let's see. Bear and breakfast sells items. There is no way to sell items in Bear and Breakfast. Is the first result.
Fantastic. All right. Well, then I'm putting
the best location to store unwanted items is the bear stash, which you can find behind the Pond Voyage truck.
Yep, the bear stash is. It's a dumpster. It's a different dumpster, you see. Oh God, no! Didn't want to do that. Let's see.
Sorry, pal.
Eh.
I did a research.
Thanks, buddy. Oh, I can throw things away, but I might need that later.
That's how they get you.
Let's see. Let's go in my inventory. Let's start. Oh, yeah, that's nice. I like that. That's very nice. Very nice. Oh. Wow, how dare you, Viv?
Reverse! Reverse! Reverse!
I saw.
Reverse!
It's the baby. She's in her bed again. He's the best kitten cat.
I envy her. I wouldn't mind being in my bed.
That's your favorite place to be, other than your.
I mean,
your
comfy it's among chair. Them. Mm. All of my chairs are comfy. I have made it so.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Jean-Luc.
Show me Picard's flute.
Show me potato salad. She's the best kitten cat. I'm going to buy one of these. Let's see what else we got here. I think I can put things on the decorative barrels. Like your bed was new. Spent a lot of time in there. We have a Tempur-Pedic bed. And we spent some money on it. And it was an investment, let me tell you. But boy, howdy, has it paid off. Good gravy, that thing is just comfortable as... it's just the best.
There's still time.
Thanks, Viv. Thanks, Viv. Well done. Can you get Dairy Queen this weekend?
Oh, Allie Beth. Reckon.
Oh, Allie Beth, that's... You should do that. Where's that one? Where's that rug? Let's remove that. Let's go to my inventory. Let's go down and grab... Oh, that is the medium red rug. Oh, I see. I see. What if I put another medium red rug? Like, I've had first medium red rug, yes, but what about second medium red rug? That's the knitted rug. That's the red rug. That's plus two. That's plus two. That's plus three to both. Let's see. Okay. Let's craft some more stuff. What else do we have here? Small vanity table. Oh, that adds plus
God three. Damn. I could actually go for something blizzard-like.
Mmm, you love a good blizzard.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, I didn't tell you the impressive statistic from yesterday's stream.
Oh, go on then.
From a full charge, this wireless headset, which was on the entire time. Only drained to 50%.
Wow, that is actually really impressive.
I know.
Oh God, go on, Viv. Just get it over with.
You're wearing pants, aren't you?
Oh God.
Wait, really?
You've never had Dairy Queen?
Huh. That's crazy.
I mean, it does make sense, though. Like, you know, like, living most of his life in Massachusetts, it's cold up there, you know.
Do they not have Dairy Queens?
They do, but they do that thing where it's, like, closed for, like a chunk of the year. Plus, you know, they got a bunch of dairy country up there, so, like, near them. So they have, you know, probably more desirable options, that kind of thing. Take care of your plant today. Make sure Krakow had water and outside time. Krakow is a plant. It's true. It's true. Also, hi, Bobo. Somerset Creamery. See? There you go. There you go. It was a brazier or whatever it was called.
Oh man, yeah, I remember that now.
Yeah, that's what it is. When they have the food, when they have the grill, that's what that's called. You gotta play with fire today? Oh God, Bobo. Jesus, Bobo, don't burn everything to the ground. Bobo's gonna burn.
Well, look, it was either her or Krakow. I think all things considered, we made the right choice.
I mean, I guess that's fucking fair. That's fair. Oakwood nightstand. All right. Let's see how this all looks now. Let's see what my bedrooms look like. That's a 19 and a 30 and a 13 and a 23. Whew, that's good. You only singe the back of the hand. Well, I mean, I guess that's... Oh, well, that's good.
That's goodly-ish.
Goodly-ish. Yeah, that's best I can offer is goodly-ish. Ooh, look. Stuff. Oh, that's a CP guy. What do we got in here? That's a level 2. These are all old drawers. Small bear painting. The jukebox is nice.
Ooh.
Man, it costs 150.
Something interesting has come by my...
Wait, mm. Yeah. Hmm.
Do they have anything like that? They don't, but that's okay.
Give me five, though.
That's I'm getting ice cream.
I must fix her Sims character's house. Things are... Boob away. Bye, Boob.
Boob? Where's Boobs?
Bobo said it. Boob away.
Oh. That sounds like a spray you would use to get rid of boobs. I'm not interested.
Oh, no. Neither am I. I mean, Bobo. Maybe it's like her party tit.
Oh, fantastic.
Some of my shit away, I would. It's too much. Makes your back hurt. Clothes don't fit right. Just take some boob away. Listen, not to
my boob away.
Not to tell you your business, but I know a guy who might be local to you, who'd be willing to take them off your hands or put them in his. You know, whichever.
But would he know what to do with them?
No, absolutely not. No, he has literally no idea what he's doing. Gonna get another one of these medium red rugs. Got any of these sensible? Those are floor lamps. I want a better lamp. Oh, small table light. All right, let's take. How much are those? 10. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I want another one. Thank you.
Perfect. Vegeta, no. Vegeta,
yes. Just died during a speed run, so now you're making it. Oh, okay. Lolly's listening to My Chemical Romance now because he's being emo about losing his dying on a speed run.
What? Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that's what happens when you try to do a speed run. Good news. We're ordering ice cream.
Hey, remember that time you ordered ice cream?
Dairy Queen's not accepting orders, so we can't get blizzards, but... We have a local ice cream place that's awesome, and so I'm getting ice cream.
Yay! Love that for you.
Thanks to my wonderful wife.
She's pretty much the best, yeah, like, you know, mine excluded.
Everyone loves their own brand.
Mm, it's true. Is it a speed run if you die? Well, it depends on how fast you die.
Exceeded expectations. I've got a watch. What does the watch do?
Lollipop dies any percent.
What does the watch do?
What does the watch do? What does the watch do?
What does the watch do?
It's being janky. Yeah. I need to reboot. It's been several days. It's been several nights.
It's been!
Here comes Lolly. Give it a minute. There's Viv. Also, hi, Pernie. Ernie, what was for Hello. Dinner tonight? What'd you eat? Anything tasty? Alright. My dinky shed's getting there. Get steak? Oh, love that for you.
She said magical words to you.
Steak is a magical... It is a magical word, and I'm a big fan of it.
Oh, that's why this is going so
Party
slow.
Potatoes and green bean casserole and rolls. Holy, but Jesus, Bernie. That's fucking... That's like ideal state for me, I gotta tell you. Oh, it's fantastic. I love that for you. I got to have, what the hell is it called? Wait, can that be placed on things? I don't think it can. Well, maybe it can. We'll find out. I had prime rib, yeah. Not once, but twice. Now. And tomorrow will be three. Prime rib the third, you see.
The official dinner of Prime Ribbington.
Okay, so that's that large plant can't be. That's fine though. That'll live there. Can I craft anything else that?
Eleven, 12.
I have to have a bar to put it in.
It was.
The number of ribs that I eat is indeed prime. I think it was, I want to say that this particular roast had three ribs, either two or three, either way, still prime. Yeah, tertiary rib, the third one. Yes. Yes, absolutely. It would, Fritz. 100%.
It was a prepared meal. It was like a beef roast and mashy taters.
Love me some mashy taters.
Sorry, I got a messages coming and such.
Are they perhaps dairy dessert related?
Well, they are, but first they were worrisome.
Oh, I see.
Because they hadn't confirmed the order.
I see.
But all is well now.
A veggie lo mein? Hey, that sounds tasty. Alright, I'm gonna need to wait and get more stuff. Your last crown this week? Your emotional support, KFC mashed potatoes? Listen, I will have KFC mashed potatoes in solidarity with you this week, Lolly.
I've only had high main.
Oh, really? Oh, this is the special shop with all of the... I don't want all of these things.
So now, because I'm me,
boy are you ever.
I have the race over here on the right screen. Uh-huh. I got you on the left screen. Excuse me. And in the middle, I now have Against the Storm.
Because the text is small and sometimes hard for me to read.
Wait, they don't have whatchamahoozes is?
No.
Accessibility options for that?
No.
That's a bunch of horsey shits.
Yeah, they do not have that. It's sometimes the astigmatism acts up, so like when I see the numbers that are in white, they're just like. Oh, Lolly. Lolly, that's a bonkins.
Oh, Jesus.
Hi, Wistie. Wistie, how are you? What did you get up to today?
Hi, Wistie. Please know that the oh, Jesus was due to Lollipop and not you, and the timing was just very poor.
Yeah, no, that's 100% Lollipop's fault, as are many things around here. Actually, let's go up here, organize my inventories. I guess I could put like one more little plant or something. Prime ribs, that's okay. Listen. So what?
How's mom?
White fawn on dark screens also mess with your astigmatism. Like, That's the thing with me, Alibeth. If I do like light theme where it's dark text on like light backgrounds and white backgrounds, that's too much altogether. So dark mode is better for me personally. But then when I go and actually like look at it, sometimes just like the dark or the white text is just like just a little much. Because I got like, you know, the starburst effect going on, but tiny.
I don't know a lot about astigmatism.
Basically, all astigmatism is meaning your eyeballs are shaped wrong. So, like, they're squished in one way or another. So, instead of, like, you know how some folks are nearsighted or farsighted? Astigmatism a lot of times presents itself as light, things that emit light are blurry. So if you've ever seen the thing with like tail lights at night, where like you see like the lines coming off of them, if you like close your eyes and squint, it's like that.
I did once.
But all the time. Yeah.
I was, I had to work an overnight at Lowe's.
Oh, yeah.
And I was so fucking tired by the end of it.
Yeah, that'll...
I shouldn't have been driving, but,
Hi, Scotch. How you doing, bud? One of those over the monitor lamps that lights your desk and it has helped a ton. Yeah, I'm thinking of starting to keep more, like, background light in here on during the day. Because it is kind of... I mean, this is my bear cave, you know? It is what it is, but I... You know. All right, let's go ahead and sleep the night. Scotch, how you doing, bud? It's good to see you. Yeah, all the starbursty lights. That's just not great. So, like, my vision is pretty damn good. It's just, like, the light will hit my eyes, and if I stare at light sources too long, then it just gets, like, the whole thing just was like, nope, we're done here for the day. And then, you know.
Please try to see again tomorrow.
It's pretty much exactly what it is, yeah. How are we doing? 19 and
honestly,
37.
You got a lot of balls walking around here trying to see stuff. We're going to put a stop to that right now.
Oh, is that so? Alright, I need more decorative stuff in here. I already got a jukebox. It's just, eh. Ooh, look. Pile of wood. Kind of a blah weekend, zero motivation, plenty to do. Ugh. Buddy,
described every weekend of my life.
I've had that for the weeks. The weekends have been fine. The weeks just...
Reckon. Oof.
Hi, Secret.
They, fucking can't keep these cars straight. It's gonna be a long fucking night if they don't get their shit together.
Get your shit together. I told them for you. You're welcome.
I mean, a long night for me, a long night for them.
Hello.
There wasn't anybody even near this guy. It's just like, I crash here.
Vision's fine, however, doing so gives you headaches. You have glasses strictly so your eyes can focus without working too hard. In other words, your eyes are lazy shits and make it your brain's problem. You know, they say the eyeball doesn't fall far from the tree or whatever. I'm okay,
who
Secret.
Says that?
I don't know. Somebody. Somebody probably somewhere said it. I'm okay. Had a really fun time yesterday. Loved playing the Satisfactories. I'll figure out words eventually, don't worry. Had a lot of fun playing that.
It's a great game.
It really is. Really is. So, yeah. Looking forward to playing more of that on stream in the future. So, yeah. I said it! Yeah, I like time and include with your plan. It's now in a police strike in tomorrow. Yeah, pretty much, Karsus. Only DoorDash so many times before you realize that you should probably get out of the house. Challenge accepted. Challenge.
I'll let you know when we reach mine.
Yeah, challenge accepted. Hand-painted drawers. Can I make hand-painted drawers? Or are those only a purchasable item? Just got done eating foodies, like some mac and cheese. Or mac and cheese. Mac and or cheese. Yes. Batsy had the mac, but not the cheese. Well, not the dairy cheese anyway. It looked very tasty, okay. Batsy.
Everyone has a house. Everyone has a job. Look at me go.
Wow. Let's brag about it. Why don't you? Wait, did I place those backwards? I think I did. Or I placed where the one backwards.
Planks. Why aren't you making... Oh, because you need a friend.
I did there place the one backwards. Hmm. Return to the Mac. Nice. Hmm? How many? That works. I can deal with that. Is this some shit out here?
Yay! Yeah.
Ice cream on the way. Ham, potatoes, Snickers salad. Okay, I gotta know.
What's a Snickers salad?
What's a Snickers salad, and how do I sign up for this newsletter?
Wait, I have to make sure it's not just a Snickers bar on top of a fucking bed of lettuce first.
Listen, this is Wisty, okay? She knows what she's about. She's not gonna come up with some bullshit like this.
No. She didn't say she made these things. She said she had these things.
She wouldn't have it. Wisty would not stand for that. Whipped cream, Wisty vanilla pudding, Snickers, and apples. Wisty would do things to not
hurt her family's feeling.
Oh, see, that's... I love that. Peach Jello stuff. Huh? You wanna do it? Okay, we'll make it. All right, B now wants Snickers salad. Banana pudding. Love me some nana pudding. Midwest salad and cool whip.
An ice cream sandwich, which is just a scoop of ice cream between two pieces of bread.
And gummy worms. Yeah. Classic Midwest salad indeed. Listen, I'm here for it, okay? The Midwest has given us many treasures. All of the dairy products that have come out of the state of Wisconsin. I don't know how offended anyone in particular will get if I call them casseroles versus hot dishes. That's an oak. Can I not put anything?
That's really a them problem.
And then, of course, you know, salads that are just whipped cream and other delicious sweet things mixed together inside the whipped cream. Of course you are, Wisty. We love you. Oh, puppy chow? Yeah? 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 Important to know the apple should be green for the crunch. Mm-hmm. And you have to offset some of that sweetness with, like, the tart. You know, that's... You gotta have a little bit of a... Gotta offset the flavor profile a little bit.
I wonder who greenlit the 70s porn music for this game.
Oh, I did.
Reckon again!
Wait, I can't put those on the nightstand? Fucking... Alright, I guess...
This broadcast started at 7 o'clock. They're only 80 laps in.
Jesus, good lord.
It's less than 1 mile, this track.
Okay, what are scotcheroos?
I like scotch eggs.
You know, I've never had a scotch egg.
What?
I've never had one.
Oh, fuck, what's the name of that? There's a place that sells them. I can't remember the fucking name of it. It's an international mall. There's like a pub there.
Okay, observe. Scotcheroos. Let's see what the scotcheroos are. Oh, these things. Oh, yeah. Okay, so they're like Rice Krispie treats, but with like peanut butter and then the chocolate layer on top. Okay. Okay, gotcha. So my thing is peanut butter, delicious. Have to be in the mood for it though. Not always in the mood. What? Every once in a while, I am so in the mood for it. Oh, sigh all you want. I know you will. Bean's disappointed because Bean's always in the mood for peanut butter. And I'm
so who the very fuck's stopping her from having it?
Well, she likes to share things with me. So we can have them together as a family.
Like, you can still enjoy treats together as a family and have two different treats.
Well, that's just preposterous. This meetup in the future, the food is going to be amazing. Okay, Karsus. You have to know about Nomster Jam. Alright. Now, no one here has ever been to a Nomster Jam.
Ahem!
Can I finish? Can I finish?
Save, I was just clearing my throat.
Uh-huh. Save for Tom. Now, Tom, would you be so kind as to explain to the good folks in the chat what Nomster Jam is?
It's like Christmas for meat.
That's a pretty apt description, yeah. So Nomster Jam, it was our annual Memorial Day barbecue. We held it 5 years in a row. nice, Perny. Also, bonk. It was our annual Memorial Day barbecue where we would get together on Memorial Day Sunday. It was my excuse to do two things. I would cook a ridiculous amount of meat. Bean liked to make several treats for the dessert undertakings. And it was also my excuse to cut a radio style promo for it, a la Monster Jam or, you know, Legally Distinct giant truck rally. So that's what I did was I cut a commercial, sent it out as the invitation to Nomster Jam, or as I'm legally obligated by myself to say it, Nomster Jam, and just had all kinds of food. Okay, so everybody brings a side to share with folks. It was a great time. There were things that I would always do, like always did hot dogs, always did a couple racks of ribs. I would do, I've done prime rib. I've done, a whole turkey. I've done the bacon explosion a couple times, which is like crispy bacon wrapped inside of pork sausage, wrapped inside of a bacon weave lattice. I've done just chicken palooza with a bunch of wings and thighs and stuff. Yes, Wisty, yes. So yeah, just fucking all of the stuff.
And usually a Mario Kart tournament would break out and lots of us would also be drunk.
Yeah, there was always something like Mario Kart we did once. There was one year when Bean and I were prepping and we turned this thing on Netflix that was just this 4-hour video of from the front of a train traveling through Norway. Okay, just winding through the mountains and stuff in Norway. And that was it. That's the whole video. So we turned it on to do prep. People showed up. They got intrigued by the train. And literally all Nomster Jam was the food and watching the train to see how long it would take for the train to finish doing its thing. And eventually everybody left and I kid you not 5 minutes after everybody finally, the last people left because they were just I don't know if I can, you know.
I have Nomster Jammed until I can Nomster Jam no more.
Yeah, and they were all right, this thing's never going to end. 5 minutes later, train was done. Fade to black. It was done. I don't remember Karsus, but I think it was the winter one. Was it the winter one? Okay, Bean says yeah. So, yeah. So, yep, that's what we did 1 year. But we just... It was my excuse to cook a shit ton of food and cut a promo for it.
Reckon again. Jesus fucking Christ.
Love you, Wisty. Have fun. Vivid's like this, but gondolas. Oh, gondolas. I love watching gondolas.
Oh, wow. They didn't even bother to throw the caution for this one.
No?
They're like, fuck it. We're done. Yellow Jeez. Flag's broken. Kiss our dicks.
Jesus Christ. Alright, let's...
Oh my god, ice cream.
Hey, remember when your lovely wife brought you ice cream?
Thank you. Thank you very much. You're the best, and I love you muchly.
That's why I made it legal.
Hey, guess what? Guess what? Are you guessing? You bear person.
Yeah.
Guess what?
What?
Reckon again. That's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah.
Well,
gondolas I will watch. I will not ride gondolas.
Procter and Gamble's getting their money's worth. They did, because it's the dirt race, they brought out a Tide and a Gain car.
Perfect.
Yeah, well, I guess who's wrecking?
Hey, Alibeth, I have it on good authority that you have ice cream. From local you and Tom's.
Honestly... This is better than, it's better than Dairy Queen. Like, this place is legit.
Listen, Dairy Queen's not designed to be, like, the best. It's designed to be good. And it's good, it's not the best.
Like, blizzards are great.
Oh, I love blizzards.
Even better than that.
Yeah. Oh, you know what's great? Speaking of blizzards and that style, concrete mixers at the Culver's. That's the good shit right there. Mm. Love me a good concrete mixer.
Reckon again. Holy shit. Okay, now they've finally thrown one. Now it's yellow again.
Beautiful. Hey, I've completed the stay for 3 guests in A24. Amazing! This concludes our foray into the roadside attraction business. Your extraordinary enterprise empire is expanding thanks to the hard work of your Pond Voyage representative. Remember, to start working on your next premium property, locate your nearest shark-like agent and press the green button. Is that a left shark? It might be. Might be. Come visit the old... Barbara, I would love to come say hello to you. You sweet old gal. Welcome to Pond Voyage Leadership and Advancement Program. You can now further improve this establishment. Successfully doing so will increase guest expectations for this location, also increasing payout and bragging rights. In order to improve this premise, you must now successfully complete the following task. Build 5 level 2 bedrooms in A24. A reward, a cool trinket that can help tell time. Folks, this may be it.
Interesting.
I
know where it is. I've been waiting.
You're making your way all over the place, aren't you? I barely got here and you're right on my track. That's right, old lady. You better watch your back or I might build you a bedroom. Snarky bear noises. We might have the watch tonight, folks. I got an hour and a half. Let's see what I can do. You seem to have made
Are you hitting on Barbara?
No, I was making snarky bear noises. I was threatening her menacingly with. No, I was threatening her menacingly with a bedroom. It's different. It's very different. All right, it's worse than saving you from. This place used to host all sorts of people, but mostly those without a lot of time on their hands. One of them, a sailor, a captain, I should say. A father to three strong boys, he had a lot of unexpected stops to make. Some would say his work was hectic, hostage to the wishes of the sea. He would make the stops so often that he'd have a regular room all to himself. One could wonder, perhaps, why his room ought to also come with regular guests all to himself. I tried swimming once, it went poor. Maybe he did. Questioning bear noises. Bonk! I suppose when the frost of the sea follows you, even ashore. You curl up to any ember you can find. He kept the books on all maritime travel, even showed it to me once. It was his pride and joy. The schedule, like clockwork, the coordinates, the ships, their names. It was so fascinating that I couldn't help myself and stashed it under a wardrobe. And he never saw it again, and neither did I. I came back here with blind hope that the chaos spared this little book. Hey, I have a book like that. There was nothing but rubble and dust, not even a standing wardrobe to look under. If you happen to come across an old leathered book, do an old lady a favor, would you? Why, what if I told you? Oh my, is that what I think it is? An old brown leathered book. Excited bear noises, like me when there's prime rib. You know, I never used to see any animals like you just roaming around. We were lucky to hear birds some days. Now you all seem to be running the place. Not that I'm complaining, you're probably more qualified anyway. You do seem like you're getting things back into shape. This road used to be full of cars and buses, people chasing each other, chasing other people's problems.
Not yet, Viv.
No, Viv, we don't know yet. Not yet. Or sometimes their own, but rarely. You never had time to look after yourself. Oh, there I go again, blabbering to a bear. What happened to all the people? Bear noises? If only you could blabber back and keep an old lady company. I seem to have fallen out of practice with that, keeping company. But I'm not here to throw a pity party. There's hardly enough booze for that. Thank you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a long walk ahead of me.
Look,
I'm not flirting with Zunder Barbara. Listen.
He's very attracted to the string on her glasses.
Listen. Hey, look! Just, okay, listen, the fact that there's a bear and the only human that he can communicate with is named Sabine, that's a little on the nose, I'm just saying. Confused duck noises. That damn shark's got people coming in droves. Damn near the lake. So the barrier up to High Lake is open. You make your way up there, look me up. I know the place inside and out. All right! I get a new region. Quack. Quack. New routes unlocked towards High Lake Dark Grove. Ooh. Ooh. All right. Okay, so I have to do more bedrooms here. Which is gonna be tough. Alright, let's do this. You can come over here. No, actually, I think I'm going to have to redo the room. Yeah, I think that's what's going to have to happen. That'll do. Let me go in here. There's some stuff back here. Let's pick that up. there any more stuff in there? No? Okay. So I have to build 3 more bedrooms. Ugh, I'm gonna have to edit those, like... one bear-sized breakfast, please. Hiltzy, no breakfast, only bear. Also, hi, Hiltzy. How you, buddy? There we go. Doing well? Good. Good to hear. Wait. Okay, so there's nothing up there. That works. Alright, I need to build a bedroom. Nope, we're gonna redo this room. I'm gonna put this back. Move you over here. Take this out. Yep, I think that's gonna work. Yep. Now let's build. Oh, I need beds. All right, let's. Which I will get to. Okay. Let's actually put this about there. That'll work. Let's go build. I'm gonna need 3, so let's make them.
Completed my ice cream.
Love that for you.
Oh. Just dove right in there. Really got after it.
Yeah. Hey, remember when you had ice cream?
Yeah. It was 4 scoops of cookie dough, my man.
Oh yeah. That's the good stuff right there. Love me some cookie dough. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Can I?
Wrecking. Oh God. Okay, that's not the. That's the third time that guy's crashed. Park him.
Hi, Kitty.
Oh,
how are you? Ooh. Excellent. Love it.
Ooh.
Mildly tipsy, but good. Listen, you gotta do what you gotta do.
Ugh.
Is there any stuff laying around here? No? No? Okay. Okay, let's... Home from a housewarming party with Mario Kart, Cards Against Humanity, and Peach Bellinis. Well, that sounds like a fun time. This is prestige level 4. Pretty good, TBH? Good. I'm glad to hear it. Good, good, good. Do I have another bed? I do. Like that. Everything's closed tomorrow. You feel a mild hangover coming on already? Oh, lovely. Well, good luck.
Have fun storming the castle or whatever.
Making soup tomorrow? Ooh. Oh, I love garlic bread and soup. Alright, folks. I think this is it. I think we're about ready. I do need to move the bathroom over just a smidge more. Oh, man. That's...
God, I love garlic bread. It's like the king of bread.
Son of a bitch.
Ugh.
McJesus? Nice, Silty. Love that for you, bud. Go back down here. So I had to move. I had to move the distillery down. Because I need the bath. I need the bathroom to be able to reach the bedrooms. So, yeah. Friday went to a pretty cool monument in your city. Three massive bronze swords stuck in a rock outcropping by the ocean. That's cool. Mark a battle that happened around the year 900. United Norway is one. Got us our first king of swords. Neat! That sounds really cool.
Sweet Christ, this is... A bunch of monkeys try to fuck a football here.
Well, that's boy, that's a sentence. All right, let's edit this. Let's add this here. Move this over here. Put the turlet over here.
Ish turlet?
No, just regular turlet. And we'll leave that there. And that means all the bedrooms. Nine.
That's German for no.
Nine. It's also not German for nine. I didn't know if you knew that.
Huh.
Ooh. Okay, kitty. I'll try to look in a few. This was the radiator. Let's see. All right, yeah. All right, let's see what we got here. Are you ready? Here we go. Is the job complete? Yes. Congratulations, you've once again proven yourself barely above minimum expectations. Guess we'll now have higher expectations for this lodge. I got a watch! What does the watch do? What does the watch do? Let's find out. This will help you know the exact time. Shows you the exact time.
Huh.
Hey, congratulations, everyone. We learned what the watch does. Look. Observe. On my mini-map. There is now a clock on the top left of it, next to where it says I'll the area. Damned. The watch, in fact, tells you the time. We have learned what the... Can Doug have a command on his stream to play this clip? God.
Uh-oh.
That doesn't sound right. Pern's like, I don't think that's what watches are for. I think they're lying to you.
You barely exceeded expectations. I've got a watch.
Oh.
What does the watch do?
16s and 12s. What does the watch do? That's not bad. Just need more decorations.
What does the watch do?
What does the watch do? I gotta reboot my machine tomorrow. Let's... Oh man, I have... Wait. Did that rename it? No, we gotta rename that. Oh, that's not gonna work for me. Can I rename this? God, it's forever gonna be bedroom 6 and I'm just... That's gonna kill me. Not turn my piece off at night? No, Kitty, I don't. No, I sure don't.
No, he totally does, but he just wants to reboot it for other reasons.
That's it. You got me.
You got the tater.
Perfect. Done. Check his Twitch tomorrow and see like 8 shoutouts from Zunder being like, what the fuck? Oh, he'll figure it out. He'll figure it out. Let's see. Alright, well, I think that's pretty much it for now. I've got... Am I all booked? Yeah, I'm booked for tomorrow. Fantastic. Oh, alright, let's go to... Wait, can I buy more different stuff from the dumpster? I can. I'm gonna wait though. How's the old dump looking over here? Ooh, look, more stuff.
You here for the dumper?
My God. Oh, you got a quest for me? No good, too tiny little rat. The gate's open. What do you want? Tell you what, there's no respect in the top-down criminal organization business anymore. Favorite soundtrack movies? Anything with techno electronic music? I mean, honestly, Karsus, Tron Legacy comes to mind. Wow, what a soundtrack! What a fucking soundtrack!
Maybe the flavors are
Thanks, Anton. Turn you into boots and see what flavor comes. Jesus Christ. The garbage grinder? That's a... Oh, is that what that is? Thor Ragnarok? Yeah, oh yeah. Not doorknobs? It's not a playground, especially around the garbage grinder. I'll rip your doorknob right off.
Mind your knob.
Blade Runner had some good music. Oh yeah, it did. It did. Yep. Your furniture you built yourself into the grinder. It'll wreck it, but you can salvage some of the materials. Ooh. Oh. Recycling. You now have unlocked the ability to recycle furniture from materials. The garbage grinder in the A24. Can take crafted furniture and salvage it for free. Recycling will only return around half the original materials rounded up. Place any crafted furniture in the input slots and click the recycle icon to start salvaging. Once done, you will find resulting materials in the output slots. You cannot salvage decorative items or anything other than crafted furniture. Oh man, this is great. Where's the bear stash?
On the bear's upper lip?
Well played. I'm gonna wreck it. Take all. Let's go. We're going in the garbage grinder. Oh, baby. Let's go. Shabby pallet beds? Another shabby pallet bed? No. Shabby wooden beds? No. None of those. Small nightstands? I think not. Whoa. This is gonna be great. I get stuff. I love stuff.
That's true.
Huge fan of stuff. Okay, so that I can't... Oh, right. It's decorative. Yep. Okay, so that's fine. Take all. Oh, fantastic. Now let's go in the dump. I'm just getting all kinds of stuff. I'm just getting all the stuff. I don't even care what I'm getting, because I'm getting so much stuff. I love all the stuff. Secret, have a good night. Hope you get some good rest. I'll see you later. Stuff. There he is. I knew it was a matter of time before you showed up.
Yeah. He's here.
Louis, how's it going, pal? Quick question. Yes, Matter. Also, hi, Matter. Not when the streak needs to live on. Listen, you're a man of dedication, and I appreciate that. Swordfish. Oh, I haven't seen swordfish in a long time. With, like, the ridiculous 7 monitor setup. Okay. That goes over. Ooh, look, stuff. Doobie-doobie-doo. I still have to raise the prestige of this place up to a level 4. And as a semi-pro gamer and all-around enjoyable guy, what, in your opinion, are the 3 best co-op games ever? Ooh. Okay, so that's tough. Because anything like this is going to be highly subjective.
Highly
subjective. Because you're going to have different genres and styles and all that kind of stuff. Honestly, Halo Infinite's campaign co-op was a ton of fun. Really enjoyed playing that. Let's see. I guess I need to... Ooh, you know what I need to get? Oh, yeah, I got plenty of cash on me. I'm good. And also, I need to set up the,
Wait.
What?
He said ever, though.
What's your point?
Okay.
Ultimate Chicken Horse, Halo ODST. Did ODST have co-op? I didn't know ODST had co-op. I only ever played it single player. Okay, I need to go get a bus sign. Oh, that's only 200. Okay. Played lots with your bro, huh? I thought ODST was just single player. Like, it was the big open world, which was really cool. But I don't know. That's maybe it's just because it's so fresh on my mind.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
maybe it's Memorex. I have been thoroughly enjoying Fortnite again. Gauntlet Legends on the N64. Ooh. There's a name I hadn't heard in a while. I've been just loving the hell out of Fortnite. I'd call it more of a wobble. Let's go in with a disclaimer. GoldenEye was not a well-made game. It was a good game. It was a fun game. It was not the most well-made game. Okay? That's why Perfect Dark was basically GoldenEye with most of the bugs fixed. GoldenEye was a really fun multiplayer game. I guess it wasn't co-op, though. Although, with screen looking... Wait. Halo 3's co-op campaign was really good. It was...
Gears of War?
Gears of War had a really good co-op as well. Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. What's over here? I do need to fix the old... Is this one of the special shops? It is a special shop. Alright. Gears 2 had the best campaign out of all of them. I haven't played Gears games in so long. The Super Mario movie today was cute. Nice. Also, hi, Kitty. Or Kitty Mon, since Electric Kitty is also here. Mushrooms.
Collectively now be known as Kid Eye.
Yes. Let's see. I need... When I played with Gears 5, it felt so much like a cash grab. I never played Gears 5. I don't think I think the last one that I played was 2.
I played a little of 5, but not enough to form an opinion on it. Which is probably telling, because it didn't grab me.
Alright, gameplay, but could have been so much better. Gotcha. Gears 3 was where they should have stopped.
It's not even that they had to stop. They just had to keep doing good.
Listen, we already had the watch thing earlier. Now this is just getting a little on the nose.
Well, they spelled it wrong for starters.
Honestly. Listen. All I'm saying is listen. Just, if you want to come hang out, just hang out. You don't have to inject yourself into the game.
But you also don't not have to.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Love it. Oh, there's the bus stop. fix the bus stop. Yay! Alright. Yay! Based off the games they made after 3, they should have stopped there. Nah, I've heard that a lot. Old trash can. Ooh, look at all that stuff. Fuel container. Man, there's just stuff everywhere around here. This is great. A crafting table. Confirm. Huzzah, crafting table.
You'll want that for crafting purposes.
Oh, okay. Hey, I got apples. I love apples. Apples, top 5 favorite fruit. Top 5 for sure. What is all of... There's a garden. The next 7 star terror rate. Ooh, okay. Okay, Lolly. What do you got? What do you got? Depends on the apple. That's fair. For me, Honeycrisp, top tier. Honeycrisp is my favorite. Plants. Holly Beth has re-entered the chat after her latest cackling fit.
Wait, does somebody call you a size queen?
Oh, for God's sake.
That's her favorite. I don't...
There it is. Look, I got potatoes. You know, I should throw these potatoes out just for that.
Oh, no, digital potatoes.
You're a digital potato.
My
jeweler's?
My one weakness.
What is all of this stuff? Corn? You know, it's got the juice, I understand.
Corn? I didn't have any corn.
This is fantastic. What's going on here? Look, it's Julia the goat. This is the last time you are not taking anything from the garden. Potatoes aren't even in season. Well, you did anyway. Typhlosion in ghost terraform. Oh, Jesus, Lolly. They got Arceus in your main line. And somewhere else. A warm, glistening potato. Tom? Mm? That is a U line if ever I've seen one. Hey, I'll never say no to a warm, glistening potato.
Yeah, well, that's how I got married.
That's also true, yeah. I'll tell you what. Wait a minute, they had Hank Evans. I'll tell you what. Listen, if at some point there's propane in this game, I swear to God. They just take.
Reckon!
Wow, that's
fantastic.
That's so strange. They haven't had any wrecks up to this point tonight. That's so weird.
Yeah, there hasn't been any in a bit because they reached the end of a stage, and so they actually stop the race and have non-competitive pit stops.
Amazing. Always caught by surprise, Julia the Goat was the only remaining resident in this huge estate. She seemed very invested in her vegetable garden, but the rest of the property didn't concern her as much. The intense aroma coming from her house signaled a knack for cooking, a hunch reinforced by Hank's rumbling tummy. Wait, do we get breakfast? Julia? Yes, it is. Listen, Julia is a goat. She's the goat. Here's a fresh coat of paint. The old captain's shack. I'm not going anywhere near a garden. D's? Sure. Sure. Captain... Oh. Like Captain D's nuts?
Yeah.
Oh. No. But Lowell got him. Look, I got Straubs. I got Straubies.
Oh, you know who loves that?
Who's that?
Loaf has entered the chat.
Oh, I see. Yes. Well, that's because Strawby is her best friend.
She's the best kitten. Strawby's her... Is she still in? He's still in her... He's still in there. Loaf. Loaf, what are you doing, baby?
She's just laying. She's laid in her little cat igloo. Her little Minnie Mouse bed. It's fine. I'm just crying about it.
Okay.
Because she's the cutest kitten's cat who has ever lived. And I cannot handle it. It is... She's just the most wonderful. And I love her. A rubble pile? A Barney rubble pile? Are you afraid? That's a Barney rubble pile, you see.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. An old chest. Holy shit. I got regular corn, I got corn on the cob, and I got popcorn. Hey, Bean, I found all the corn. It's corn in all of its forms. Except for creamed. No candy corn. Well, that's also fair. That's fair.
Candy corn.
Love candy corn.
That's so good. Fair.
Bandit shopping cart. Creamed corn. Yes, I said creamed corn. Yes.
He did say that. I heard him.
Yep. Creamed corn. Those are the words that just left my mouth. Yes. It is corn that you take the corn and you kind of smash it a little bit and you mix it in a cream mixture. And just to be clear, Louis, we're talking sweet corn. Old Colonel Sweet Corn.
Old Colonel Sweet Corn.
Tom's getting all wistful back there. God, I got tomatoes now? Oh my god. I'm a tomato. What is this? Broadcast station sign. Broadcast station? Oh.
Well, that's really good for broadcasting.
I love broadcasting.
I know you do.
Something back there? No. Love me some strawberries. Corn and cream do not belong together. Okay. And I shouldn't be eating sheep innards, but there you are. In all of your
can, no less.
Out of a can. Well, 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 if it isn't Finn. Enjoy today. You can't pay your debt from the grave. Haggis is lovely. Okay, weirdo. But your children can. Hello, voice box person. Be part of the next exciting experience. Enticing escape. Electrifying. Oh, yeah. Individualism does not make the cogs turn faster. Wow, that's capitalism at its finest. Welcome to High Lake, the Amber Jewel, the pride of the valley, the Great Depression. And we're talking sunken landforms, not your reasons for staying in bed. The Golden Plateau, in geological terms, of course, not your late teens. The Captain's Estate is a perfect destination for a premium development. A quaint, family-centric farmhouse is ideal for hosting dozens of loud, unfamiliar strangers. As always, a regrettable minimum standard is required to open this location. Okay. Let's see. Let's repair the farmhouse. Welcome to the High Lake Farmhouse. Would you like to repair it? Yes, I would love to. Clear it out. All right, let's go. love finding stuff. Destroyed debris, more crap. Love all the crap. It'd be weird, but you're being weird. Fantastic food. Mm. Yeah, that's just like your opinion, man. Destroyed washing machine, little couch. There's a little porch out here. Look at that little porch. Wait a minute.
Porch guy, yeah.
Oh.
Big porch times in the city.
Mm-hmm. This has got a second level to it. Love that. Is the structure clear of any debris? Yep. All right. Gather the construction materials we need to repair. Pinewood planks, stone bricks, glass panels, and iron nails. I think I have all of that.
I got a chivo.
I love chivos. Get your butt to work.
And I've leveled up.
Ooh. Well, that's pretty. Oh, look at this. This is nice. Why watch the world through a screen when you can trade it in for the real thing? Now accepting trade-ins for high-definition electronics at any pawn location. Humankind has fought many arduous battles, none more impressive than the one against nature itself. A solid roof over our heads and a dry floor to sleep on have become the preferred way of life for many. And the reward for that victory? The opportunity to profit from taking all of it away. This area supports the development of outdoor facilities, an open-air, untamed, raw experience at the mercy of dangerous creatures and savage beasts. I also get pretty grumpy in the morning. Closed off in a small area with a fence and a gate, of course. Of course. As you know, patron health and safety are our main concern, so any outdoor expansions need to be certified by a forestry specialist. Failing to do so will deprive your more adventurous guests from the true experience of paying extra to sit outside. Love that. Find a way to prepare the farmhouse. I did that, so let me go back and talk to Julia, the goat. Love us a Julia, who is a goat. What's this? Chamomile tea, spicy linden. Ooh, look at all this. Look at all these fancy teas. So fancy. Perfect for an elegant dinner party. Hello. So clean. Is that fresh coat of paint? It is. I've never seen it sparkle like that. So you're here for my potatoes. That's also Tom. I'm still not sure you're not here for my potatoes. He says that to Louis.
Well,
thanks for the work, buddy.
You can never be too sure.
Tom on his deathbed to Alibeth. I'm still not sure you're not here for my potatoes. Overwatch is calling. Well, Louis, enjoy your future rage.
Mm-hmm.
This is the captain's estate, and that old pile of rust and mold is the farmhouse.
I also sometimes am just sitting around going, gosh, you know what? I'd love to be fucking furious right now.
Well, he's Scottish, so he's, you know, that's his natural state. It used to be the biggest private property in the valley. The lady captain and little captain kids would spend every summer here, although he was never with them. He spent most of his time up the hill in the big radio dish building. What made you come up such a long way from home? I met a shark that asked me for help to get humans to come back. You're here to rob me. You don't have to put on a show.
You'll never guess what just happened.
Did you win the race? Is it over? Was there no wrecking whatsoever?
Wrecking! They're wrecking! There's still 75 fucking laps to go.
I got a rug in my house that lies less than you. Jesus, Julia. I'm sure your dolphin friend has met. He's a shark! Okay, you convinced.
Wow, Julia's kind of a bitch.
Well, listen, if people kept stealing your potatoes, you'd be a bit of an asshole too. Oh, so you know.
Oh, I don't need people to steal any potatoes for that.
Boy howdy, you don't have to tell me. It's called sage. I use it in my teas and peach juice. It doesn't grow in the light, so you won't find it outside the thicker woods. Look west of sawdust, but you shouldn't step foot beyond that barrier, if you had any sense. Alright.
Yeah, I don't think I'm buying Russell Crowe as a priest, but thanks for trying.
Scoozy?
He's, there's a new Exorcist movie, and he's a priest.
No. No. Oh man, there's so much good food out here.
That's my favorite kind of food.
It's good food?
Yeah.
What if I were to tell you that some of those good foods are in fact potatoes?
Perfect! Man!
It's, listen,
everything's coming up Millhouse all of a sudden.
It's like everything, it's like they got all your letters, pal.
Love that for me.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Hello, Tug. Goodbye, Tug.
I mean, Louis, you say that like I wouldn't say that whether or not you were here.
Hey, it's Barbara.
Hi, Barbara. What a nice old lady.
She really is.
And just, she's trying to get some of that bear dick.
I don't think she is there, bud. I don't think that's... Nope. Nope. I don't. Nope. Only who can prevent forest fires?
She wants you to fill her like a prescription.
Why are you like this?
Senior.
Just bear things. God damn it, Hilti. With insurance approval. Yeah, good luck, Lolly. Is that it for that anymore? I can tell you which mushrooms will make you feel funny. Most people don't mind a little dirt on their butt or smoke in their face, but in limited controlled quantities. Small objects in a childproof. Jesus Christ. Oh my god. What's that? That's Pinefall. Oh, I can't go to Pinefall yet. Herbs. I got some herbs. Like, maybe Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass. It's hard to say, though. The hell is this? A billboard? Oh, I can fix a billboard. Yeah, screw it. Let's fix the billboard. But look at that! A monument to capitalism reveals itself before you. It's very pretty. Yeah, that's... Alibeth, that's... Boy, howdy, that's a... That is a sad but excellent point. That's... In my defense, I knew that years before meeting Senior. I knew that Senior was the reason that Tom is like this. Electronics pile. I'm just gonna clean all this up now.
That's kind of my favorite part. It's like when the building is just completely gross, and I get to clean it out.
You like?
I don't know why.
Because it gives you a chance to make things clean and no longer dirty. Ooh, more tomats. Love some tomats. All right, I gotta go to Dark Grove. It's west of the Sawdust. Is that what it's called? Yeah. Okay. That's look. Whatever. I mean, maybe. I keep showing back up here, so I must be a glutton for punishment. And what was that? Was that some crap? Love crap on the ground.
Barbara wants you to punish her.
I love that there's this fuel container keeps showing up. All right, camp sign. Would you like to repair it? Yes. Looks like the work site is good to go. Gather construction materials needed. Plywood planks, stone bricks, and copper plates. I think I got all of that. Yes? 6, 6, and 5. Oh, yeah, I got plenty. Yep. All right. Just hang out. I choose to? Oh, for fuck's sake, Hiltzy. Mushroom. You stifle yourself down there.
You made him in a lab, remember?
Not him. Halibeth, the cackle fuck. Stifle yourself, Edith.
Oh, Archie!
Stifle yourself, Edith. We're supposed to be incognitus.
Oh, God.
Reckon!
Oh, I need a Badger t-shirt. That would be awesome.
Oh, they didn't throw a yellow for that one.
Oh, don't worry. I'm sure they will. Yay!
Good Lord, you can't see fucking anything out of these windshields.
Wait, you moved. Oh, I see. Oh, you're over here. Yes, ma'am. So I'm just missing a bit of fuel and I left my canister behind. Sure, you need fuel? Listen, I got fuel. If you want fuel, I got you fuel.
You know, I can get you fuel by 3 o'clock.
Finishing my coffee. Grams thought is to make it feel like the greatest waiting room in the world. It should be relaxing and quiet, but just temporary enough. So that you don't overstay your welcome. You don't have to worry about that. Congratulations, you've unlocked a new crafting recipe. S'more Station. Oh, I love s'mores.
Now that's a station I'm interested in.
I don't even know what s'mores are. You know, Sophia, those little graham crackers with the chocolate. Don't forget the marshmallow. Don't forget the marshmallow. Oops. Sitting logs, small campfires.
Sitting logs are a lot like regular logs. It really depends what you're doing with them.
That's true. Ever had a banana boat? What's a banana boat? All right, the campfire is a type of special room that can only be built in certain areas outdoors. It's perfect for the more adventurous guests who prefer a moonlit wiener over an open flame. Requires a fire, a seating object, and a dispenser to be functional, and can only be built in specially designated outdoor areas. Some guests specifically look for campfires during their stays. Perny, thank you for gifting a sub to Banana Boat. Fantastic. All right.
I am a banana. Moonlit wiener. Ooh. I think that just materialized there.
Huh. I've never heard of that, Hilti.
Kill one strip, you cut a trench, put a mini marshmallows. Let's close the peel. Wrap it up in tinfoil. Yeah, no, I've never heard that either. That's wild.
Sounds interesting, though.
I try it.
It's messy as fuck.
Listen, this is from the same people that brought us poutine, so.
And poutang. Or is that just Barbara?
It's called touch grass. You know what? I'm going to come back. I am going to go find the... I'm going to sawdust.
You know, she can take her teeth out.
Big bear chase me. Oh my god, Tay.
Give you a gummer you'll never forget.
For fuck's sake. Fun banana fact. Bananas naturally split into even thirds if you press into the tip.
And they're wrecking again.
Oh, Hilti, he's in peak Tom form today.
You know how these racing cars get me all antsy in my pantsy.
Well, boy, do I ever. Which tip? All the tips.
What the fuck? He just started spinning out down the straightaway? Come on, man.
This is natural spicy, right? Exactly.
I could do at least this good.
Herbs?
They're just doing nothing and crashing into each other. I can do that. Pay me.
Purple lilies, what are these? Mushroom. Making dinner since kiddo's asleep? Ooh, what you making, Tay? What you making? Sage. There's that sage.
Oh. When we're killing off Doug?
Yeah.
We can send Ed Vance with him.
All right. Sure.
Like, imagine being enough of a bootlicker to be just hanging out at Ed Vance Auto Parts all day for no reason other than to cheer on people changing batteries.
I mean, I can't say much. I go and hang out at the Microsoft campus when I'm in Seattle, so. It's a cheaty day because your abdominal muscles are more for like four. Oof. Chicken stir fry and onion rings. Fuck yeah, bud. Gus, what the fuck are you doing up here? Never meant to say nice things about you. Yeah, well, you can't just do that to people. You could ruin someone's day. That's different. It wasn't about me. I thought I'd start my day off right with a little self-terror. Yes, Gus is wearing both a tie and a bow tie. Gus is wearing a bow tie over his necktie, yes. We decided that you might be Gus. That tracks, Bernie. Beats washing your face with water.
and accidentally giving you the impression that I'm a space scientist or something, I like to scavenge. It's what I do. Every nook and cranny and fish out the little artifacts the universe forgot about. Perny, how are you on knickknacks? Where do you stand on knickknacks? This tower here is old, like really old. You can tell by the fact that there isn't a tower anymore. The tie, bow tie tied to a tie. I think it's a bow tie tied to a tie, if I'm looking at it right. Or maybe it's a clip-on bow tie that's clipped onto the necktie that appears to be tied around his neck. Yeah, you love a good necktie? Then you may, in fact, be Gus. Like a nerd in a board game shop, I dive right in and get my little trinket fix. No one can tell me not to. That's Bernie. This is looking like a damning case. A little green jacket. I found it in the White House up the mountain. I roll around on the garbage dump once a week to keep it fresh. And this whole thing has actually gotten pretty musty and I can't get the mud smell out of it. I should probably change it soon. Hey, pickin's been slim since the old grub department. You wouldn't happen to have anything to gnaw on, would you? An egg dippy. Alright. That is also how you bathe. Well, listen, you know. You do you, pal. That large cup of sauce from Raising Cane's. I didn't get the large one, but I still have some from the Cane's run we made last week. Bag of seeds? Who knows how old these seeds are? Alright, I'll take them. Love a good quest item. Okay, I think I got pretty much cleared out of here in Dark Grove, so let's skadoodle. The 22-ounce sauce. I didn't actually make the run myself. Bean's family grabbed it for us. But yeah, no, 100%.
Hi, it's me, Stan.
Beautiful. Thanks for the thanks for the shit color there, pal. That's yeah. You good? You good?
Nope.
Correct. Oh my god. This shit show has shit colors now. Yeah, that's... Tay, you're not fucking wrong, pal. You're not fucking wrong. Jesus Christ. Alright, so listen. I need to... Need to build a camp. Ooh, what's this stuff? I saw stuff. That's apples. I love apples. Alright, let's make us a campfire.
I'm a pest.
More than you know. Looks like the toilet in Bean's bathroom once Tom was done in there. You should clip that as proof that he's a pest. Alibeth, as long as he's breathing, he is a pest. We don't need further proof. We have it.
There's a lot of clips that could be used in a court of law.
Well, cannot be placed... Tom shit stains porcelain confirmed. Yep, Tom shit stains porcelain. gonna have to build a room. Oh, I see. I see. It has to be. Okay. That makes sense.
35 to go. Can we make it?
No.
There's a nice fight for the lead happening right now.
I can dig that. All right. I need more of them. Shit. Craft one more than their sitting logs. As opposed to a different kind of log that Tom is more familiar with.
Like a ledger of errors from a program?
Well, I was thinking of as opposed to a sitting log, a shitting log, but sure, that works too.
I don't get it.
Yeah, it's fine. Don't worry, your toilet will later.
Probably tomorrow.
You can call it your captain's log.
Uh-oh. Ooh, he saved it.
There's Julia. Find any sage? I did. I found several sage.
It's so, in my butt.
So musty and crisp. About to shit his pants there. No. No, only other people shit Tom's pants. And Tom only shits other people's pants, see? That's why Tom is the villain known as Brown Note. Because he shits other people's pants.
I'm not Brown Note. I just created the character.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there they go!
Tom's very excited about all of the vroom vroom cars going kabooms. Going crunch crunch.
It's also a fight for the lead, so it's extra exciting.
Sweet, sour, buttery, earthy, smoky, tangy. Man, I love those are all of my favorite flavors. I didn't know I could taste words before.
And there we go. Reckon.
Okay. Zunder's ice bear with Tom be brown bear? No. Tom is just a potato. Hey, I can actually get things from the garden now. Haven't had a big table the whole family would sit around. Alright, little dinner stool. Small plywood table, tiny buffet. I love a buffet. Jesus Christ, I love a buffet. I need a buffet.
Bean, we need a buffet soon.
Okay.
Doesn't Bean hate the buffet?
No, Bean's fine with buffet.
Does she just hate the shitty Chinese buffet we used to go to?
That one in Golden Corral. She hates both of those. But the shitty Chinese buffet.
Golden Corral ever reopen?
Not the one here, not the one closest to us, no. By the way, you remember the shitty Chinese buffet, the one in the big red building?
Yeah, I know what happened to it.
Yep, that's honestly a fucking crime is what happened to it. So, we had this old, like, really shitty red building, this two-story building, which God only knows what the second story was for, but the first story was a Chinese buffet. Yeah. Someone that lives near you that likes shitty buffets, two of them even. Listen... Find me a shitty buffet. Molly, find the shitty buffet. We'll figure it out from there. And they finally the shitty Chinese buffet closed after the panini started. Then it got the land and the building got purchased. And what happened? They tore down my shitty Chinese buffet and put a fucking Chick-fil-A there. It was bullshit. Dining rooms are rooms where your guests can consume meals. Craft and place a serving table, a table and a chair to make it functional and give food score. Meals added in the serving table will give out their food score to guests. Guests will consume these meals usually 3 times a day. Each dining room will affect an entire building, so resorts with multiple buildings will require multiple dining rooms. Raw ingredients will not award food score, only cooked meals will. Lower level serving tables have fewer slots available to fit meals, while higher level serving tables will have more meal slots.
No, actually terrible. Nobody wants fucking hate chicken.
I don't, yeah. They got rid of my delicious Chinese buffet and put a fucking Chick-fil-A there.
Oh, man, it was so cheap.
Yeah, this place was like, I could go in and get all I could eat and a drink for like fucking $12. It was the best.
And you could get all that several people could eat.
Yeah, you and I could, bud, that's for sure.
Man, maybe that's why they closed. Maybe it's our fault.
Well, maybe. Get more of that there fuel. Okay. To build a dining room. Where's my... Alright, let's build food. Dining room.
Again.
Okay, I need to build.
Christ on sale.
Tiny buffet, table. Alright, let's see how many of these I can put in here. Okay, tiny buffet goes here. Tiny buffet, you live there.
I miss Golden Corral breakfast buffet, is what I miss.
Oh, God, yes.
We did have good breakfast buffet in when we went to Charlotte for my birthday.
Did you?
The hotel had a fantastic breakfast buffet.
Jesus Christ. All right, let's... Let's see if that works. Okay. Need someplace that has a red plastic cups, crushed ice, and cherry coke. Some sort of breaded shrimp on the buffet. Yeah, Carsis, this was basically exactly like that.
The old Pizza Hut cups.
Oh, God, I love the Pizza Hut cups. Let's see. Alright, let's start placing these. Oh, for fuck's sake, seriously? Thank you.
time.
Yeah, yeah. Pizza Hut had those cups. They were the that was the best stuff. Well, I built a functional dining room.
CeCe's. Now there's a buffet.
CeCe's. Oh. Yep. Love CeCe's. And CeCe's, you knew what you were getting. Remember when Pizza Hut had buffets, though?
Yep.
You remember KFC buffets?
No.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Few and far between, but yeah. One of my hometown was one for a while. Ponderosa / Bonanza, Ryan Steakhouse, Shoney's. You want to talk about breakfast buffet? Shoney's was it. Shoney's was the breakfast buffet. Back in like 80s and early 90s. If you wanted
that
breakfast
buffet.
That was
the first place I ever had a breakfast buffet.
Yeah, same, pal. Same. That was it. That was the breakfast buffet of the gods.
Blew my fucking mind. And then that closed and it got replaced. Jesus. It got replaced by a country kitchen, but not buffet.
Ugh. Pizza Hut, where you lived before you moved to North Carolina, still had a buffet? There was like one or two here still. Ooh, new items at Ipswich's. New items at Pond Voyage. Cast iron stove. Puny cutting board. Puny cutting board. Alright, kitchens are rooms where you can cook meals. They require either a cutting board, cooker, griddle, or microwave. Not all objects are required. Kitchen objects are noisy and smell funny, which means they carry a negative decoration score. Guests will not interact with kitchens, however, kitchens will apply the negative decoration score in an area of effect around them. This debuff will affect any bedrooms built next to kitchens, as well as the overall prestige score in that resort. Place plenty of decoration items to offset the negative effects of kitchen objects. You can see the debuff area by clicking on the room while in build mode. There's a Shoney's in Nashville. That tracks. That tracks. Shoney's is very much a southern thing with Shoney Bear. Man, I miss Pizza Hut buffets. Onion. I love onion. What's this? Some more herbs. A pizza ranch? No, what's a pizza ranch? I've never heard of that. All right, let's build a...
Oh boy, here we fucking go. It's gonna be a restart with 8 to go. And caution.
Sweet. It's like Spud Ranch in Texas. They have a little Chinese buffet restaurant here in town that has hibachi with it, so you get all you can eat hibachi with a buffet purchase too.
Wow, they didn't throw.
We have few of those here in Tampa, Tay. Like no buffets there. Hiltzy, buddy, you live on a godforsaken island. Negative 10. Everything's in tip-top shape. Love that. Hey, it's a peninsula. Listen. Don't get snippy with me. It's like a Christmas miracle for us. B, it's the capital city of it, and you'd think of the... Twin City of Lakes here, we'd have at least one. Well, whose fault is that? I don't know any cooking recipes. I honestly don't know. Well, that's fair, pal. Took, I need you to get some more stuff. I need some more different and better stuff. Man, I'm getting all kinds of stuff. Here, Julia, I made a kitchen. I did.
Please give me rewards.
Yep. What am I waiting for? Okay. The smell is definitely all natural. I'm going to be picky from the get-go. Grab some taters from the garden and some mint next to the lake. Give your new kitchen a spin. Welcome to cooking. Your goal is to follow recipes by matching ingredient items with cooking method cards. Interact with any placed cooking object. Wait, there's a cook. It's a mini game? Oh, fuck. Interact with any placed cooking object to bring up the cooking screen. Any object in a kitchen will bring up the same interface. You have to learn at least one recipe before you're able to access cooking. Each cooking object you place in the kitchen will give access to cooking cards in the interface. Higher level cooking objects will yield new cards and a larger number of overall cards. Different recipes require different cooking method cards, which can hold ingredients. Step by step, go to the recipe book and pick a recipe, then pick the appropriate cards from your deck. Put down a card in a cooking slot. Place the ingredient from your inventory into the cooking slot that has a card. Some cards require fuel to function, so make sure you have a fuel card on an empty slot. Place fuel in the occupied fuel slot from your inventory. Press the cook button and wait for your food to be ready. Remember, the more objects you place, the more cards you gain access to. I think we're about to cook.
Christopher Bell.
Oh. All right. Dr. Pepper. I'm not much of a Dr. Pepper, but boy, you give me a good orange soda and I'm there.
Yeah, I've never been much of a fan of the good doctor.
Hey, that's it? Really? Damn. Alright, let's place this thing, see if I can make some mashed potatoes for Tom before I quit for the night.
Mmm. It's a very good preparation of potato.
Shut up, baby, I know it. Did I not actually make the stove? Oh, I guess I didn't. Where the hell is it? Wait a minute. Oh my god, am I out of inventory space? I'm gonna put this in the bear stash for now. Hi, Jalen. I'm about to be done for the night, but hi. Oh my god, I ran out of... I have limited inventory space. Well, today the fuck I learned. Alright, I'm making mashed taters for Tom. Alright. Okay, we'll put one there. Let's put... what? Put one potato in there to boil and one fuel into the fire. Yes? Okay.
That's all you have to do is boil a potato? I've been doing this the hard way.
Boil? Oh, I need two potato. I need two potato. And two wood. Okay. Here we go. Oh, making mashed potato. Figure out what the watch says. Yes, it tells time, as it turns out, Viv. If you look right above the word recipes in the top right, next to the word High Lake, you can see there is a clock. That's what the watch does. Great, wrap it up. All right, fine. All right, but I had to make Tom mashed potatoes. Alright, let's, that'll do it. That'll do it for tonight. Oh, yeah, as it turns out, the watch tells time. Who knew? But yes, I made Tom, I made you some mashed potatoes. I hope you enjoy them.
Oh, hey, thanks.
Yeah, no, it's my pleasure. My pleasure. Alright, we'll pick up more Bear and Breakfast tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow we'll get to the breakfast part. We had, at best, a lunch or dinner side. But, you know, we'll get there. Breakfast maybe tomorrow, so we can cook stuff now. I can cook two things. Mashed potatoes and mint tea, but you know what? It's a start. We'll get there. Anyway, yeah. That's that. And, yeah. Alright, let's get out of here. Who is doing stuff and or things? Speaking of goats, what's Julia playing? Antechamber? I don't know what that is. I have no clue what that is, but we're gonna go find out. It's very strangely colored. That's fine. You know what? That's fine. Alright, let's go raid Julia. It hates chambers for one? Oh, I see. What if it just hates the one chamber? All the other chambers are fine, but that one, like, fuck it in particular, it knows what it did. I don't know. Anyway, there's the raid message. You know that, Julia? I also know that, Julia. I'm very familiar. Alright, let's go give Julia some love. Hey, I'll see y'all tomorrow for more Bear and Breakfast. Hopefully we'll have both Bear and Breakfast tomorrow. And yeah, we'll see how our new stuff works out. In the meantime, hey, be good to yourselves, be good to each other, and I'll see you tomorrow for more stuff. Bye.